was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke to the word of God boldly. Here I would like to emphasize to each and everyone, when the disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit, they spoke the word of God very, very boldly. That happens after a worship service. That happens after a prayer meeting. That happens after a Bible study. How many of you, in the past, 24 weeks, have speak boldly about Jesus Christ after you came from the worship service? How many of you have spoke boldly about Jesus Christ after you came from a Bible study? How many of you have spoke boldly about Jesus Christ when he came from prayer meeting? And wrong answer. Kahit walang sagot, wrong answer. Or should I rephrase the question? How many of you have the strength to attend prayer meeting? How many of you have the strength to attend Bible study? Okay, that's regular things. Mahirap talaga dahil may work. How many of you have strongly attend worship service on a weekly basis? And again, parang pinapagalitan ako ni Pastor, ha? Parang ako yun. Ha? So ang dami nyo naman. Lahat kayo pinatatamaan ko? Hindi siguro. And then yet, as was mentioned in Acts 9:17, this is actually the story of Saul. Everyone knows Saul?
Amen.
Who is Saul? He is now the pole. Okay? It happens actually when he was on the way to going to the Holy Land, and he was stopped by and the Lord gave him really a miracle and challenge in his life. He was blinded for 3 days. He's actually persecuting all the disciples. He is persecuting all the apostles of Jesus Christ. Literally persecuting. Kinikusyon niya, pinapakulong niya. And he is really the persecutor of God's apostles. And yet, God made a miracle in him. He is blinded for 3 days without seeing anything. And then to express the power of the Lord, God uses Ananias to touch him, and then he again see the light of the Lord. Lord is very, we are very grateful to the Lord kasi hindi niya tayo kailangan bulagin para makakita sa Panginoon. Para salamat tayo, nababasa natin, we can read the Bible, we can read the scripture, we can read the preaching. We're actually a spoiled church. You know what? Other churches, even in the Philippines, probably if you come to the Philippines, wala silang air-conditioned room. They don't have comfortable chairs. They don't have bountiful food after the worship service. They don't have even a monitor to see what the pastor is preaching. And yet, we are very tired to go to the worship service. We are very challenged to go to the worship service. And sometimes, matutulog lang tayo sa worship service. See again and be filled with the Holy Spirit. He see again. So each and every one of us, let us see. Let us really open our eyes to see again the words of the Holy Spirit. And then feeling of the Holy Spirit to continue is progressively. Ito, maraming example dito, mga tayong lahat narito. Even me, myself, I would admit it happened to me progressively. What we meant by progressive feeling of the Holy Spirit? Nakakilala na sa Panginoon, binigyan na ng kapatawaran, already accepted Jesus Christ, been forgiven, have accepted, been freed with sin, and yet, still doing the same things as before. Hindi ba o hindi ba? So same thing as before, progressively, paunti-unti, it's always a process. We treat it as a process. We're not same as before. But then again, we all should be glad. Tell to yourself, we all should be glad. Think about yourself, not so long ago. 1 year, 6 months, those who are really newcomer, newly accepted Jesus Christ, think about yourself few months ago. Where are you right now compared to before? If your answer is, ah, Pastor, same as before, ganun pa rin, then you know already the answer. If answer na kagaya tuloy ako sa Pastor George, you know already the answer where you are in the Holy Spirit. If there's no changes in your life, if still sin is occupying your heart, if still you can say vulgar words, if lying is just normal, if just cursing is normal, then my brothers and sisters, where are you right now? Ephesians 5:18, do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Holy Spirit. Again, here it's mentioned, be filled with the Holy Spirit. We are thinking about drinking of wine. Don't take it literally and physically. Where are we when we say drunken in wine? It's about our old self. Kung ano tayo before, doon tayo nalulunod. Our old self. We're still very happy of what we're doing before. Ni hindi nga tayo makapagdala ng kaluluwa sa panambahan. Kasi even ourselves, nahihiya tayo mag-share. Why? Is my life worth sharing? You ask yourself, is my life worth sharing? Then you can answer. Why it's difficult for us to bring souls into the church. It should start from us. It is really a progressive approach. But if you're already there more than 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, hindi na po progress yan. There's something wrong. And then what's next? After a failure. Why after a failure? Bakit once we fail in our life, in our challenges in life, doon lang tayo bumabalik sa Panginoon. As a classic example, Jesus' disciples, after God is crucified, after He died into the cross, then what happened? They go back to what they were doing before. They go back to fishing, they go back to their normal life, back to the what they were doing before, back to the way they were. So same like some other Christians. When they fail, they go back to what they're doing before. Kasi it's a failure. Parang magtataka like, for example, bakit ang Kristiyanong ito napaka-init now? It's very, very active, very strong to the Lord. And yet, after a month, pahinga na naman. Wala na naman uli sa parambahan. Kasi may pinagdadaanan. Is it that really the aim of the Lord? That sometimes we're telling ourselves, hindi mo na ako mag-church today kasi may nararamdaman ako. Hindi mo na ako mag-church today kasi I have some bad feelings. The more you need to attend church. Because sino ang mag-feel of your failure? Sino ang mag-upset, mag-remove ng failure mo? It's only the Lord. It's only Jesus Christ. It's really a vicious cycle because once you start skipping the worship service, once you start skipping the Bible study, once you start skipping, for example, the prayer meeting, it will be stagnant in your heart. Nag-upset na ako today, I can again upset next week and again another next week. Then who will fill you in? Sino maglalagay uli ng Holy Spirit in you? To have that